wait. Don't tell me you're Diana Brock.
Don't tell me you're Alan Rush.
I just thought you'd be more,
And I thought you'd be taller.
Please. I do appreciate your coming.
Well, after the flowers, the chocolates, the pre-Concord tickets, the hotel suite of my choice, and all my expenses taken care of, how could I refuse? You're an extremely generous man for a total stranger.
Scotch and water.
Oh, you know what I just love? It's about this much beluga.
So, you must be wondering why I brought you here.
No, not really. But you can tell me if you like.
I have a little business deal to propose. Sell me your stake in Brock's company.
Now, why would I want to do that?
Because he shanghaied me out of my magazine, Communique.
You mean Brock owns Communique? Well, that's a real improvement over Rod and Real Digest, isn't it?
Listen, I have done my homework. I know Brock stole your father's company out from under him. I'm offering the best chance you're ever going to have in your life to make him pay.
Alan, my daddy's company was a 5,000-watt country and western station in Louisiana Cowtown. Off of that, Brock built this humongous big media empire. And thanks to him, my life has been nice and comfortable all these years. Now, why would I want you to have any kind of control over Brock Communications when you can't even protect one little magazine? But it's been great to meet you, and thank you for everything. Oh, and I hope you don't mind if I stay an extra day. As long as I'm here, I'd like to do some shopping.
Something you should know about me. I don't take no for an answer very well.
Then maybe you shouldn't try to do business with a Brock. Brock.
Good Lord. What in the hell are you doing here?
I know it's a shock, darling, but try not to be rude. I heard. Oh. We got a new magazine. I am so excited. And you know how much I love a good magazine. And here I thought you'd never buy anything that didn't have an animal on the cover.
Diana, what do you want?
Why don't we start with a door? So all of this is ours. All these paintings, these people. Oh. And who gets this big office?
Excuse me, can I help you?
Oh, I love the accent. What is that? Australian outback by way of Piccadilly Circus?
Please excuse the interruption. This is Rachel Dennis, who is the editor of the magazine. Rachel, this is... One of my stockholders.
The one he used to be married to. Darling, I never knew you to be so coy.
Please, sit down.
I like her. She's cute. Very, EIT.
I'm sorry.
Eurotrash, in training.
That's enough.
Whoops.
All right, Diana, you've had your fun. Now, why don't you tell me what you're doing here?
Oh, I will. You can take me to lunch. I'll pick you up at 12:30. Oh, and Brock. Nice to see you, too. The best tables, the best restaurants. Everyone bowing and scraping when you walk by. You've changed.
You haven't. You still like the superficial things in life.
Now, tell the truth. Aren't you just a little bit glad to see me?
No.
Oh, come on, Brock. This is an occasion. Chance to catch up. Laugh about old times. Tell each other how good we look. Find out what's new. Okay. I'll go first. Are you, seeing anyone?
No, and I have no interest in hearing your laundry list.
Well, you're as much fun as ever.
No games, Dan. I want to know what you're doing here.
Darling, this is New York City. I came to shop, see some friends, take in some shows. Okay. I admit it, I was curious, but can you blame me? You, right here in the middle of Manhattan?
What about Jordan?
What about Jordan?
Are you planning to see her?
Of course. Not that you have any right to throw that particular stone. When was the last time you saw Tyler?
When he needed money.
Oh, Brock, let's not fight. I just wanted to have lunch with my ex-husband. Do you have to sit there looking at me like I'm some kind of letter bomb?
You will forgive me if I don't exactly take your word at face value.
You can't still be angry with me after all this time, can you?
I hate to burst your self-involved bubble, Diana, but I hadn't thought about you for years.
Well, it's a good thing we're not playing poker, darling, because I'd clear you out just like that.
I quit gambling a long time ago.
Oh, really? Well, you're having lunch with me, aren't you? Oh, here you go.
I assume you'll be wanting a limousine to the airport.
Why? Don't you have a helicopter?
Of course.
Ah, the very woman I was hoping to see.
Well, come to say goodbye, Alan. I should really thank you for such a lovely time.
Yeah, you really should. Consider this my going away present.
Oh?
A little something for your photo album.
Oh, pictures? Of what?
My wife. The next Mrs. Adam Brock. Nice trip.
Mrs. Brock, can I help you with your bags?
Yes. Take them back up to my room. Oh, baby.
Mother?
Oh, baby, baby. Oh, let me look at you. You are absolutely gorgeous. I'd hardly know you.
Well, it has been 12 years.
Please, don't be like that. I know it's hard for you, but it's hard for me, too.
What is? Cramming me into your schedule?
Okay, I deserve that. It's just that I've been so nervous about seeing you. It's been so many years. God knows what your father's been saying about me.
Actually, very little.
Please, don't be so angry. I have a lot to make up for, and I'm going to do it, starting right here, right now.
I appreciate the thought, Mother, but I have to get to work.
Jordan, please. I know I missed a lot, more than I meant to. But can't you give me just a few minutes?
Would you like some coffee?
Yes. I'd like that very much. I must say, this isn't at all where I expected to find you.
What do you mean?
Well, this neighborhood. Absolutely petrified to get out of my cab. Ludicrous, really. What happened? You couldn't find anything at Trump Tower? So you settled for this?
I'm an associate editor at a publishing house. I make nearly enough money to live in Trump Tower.
Well, you should talk to your father about that. I'm sure he'd buy you the whole damn building.
I'm not gonna live off Dad. He made his own way, and I'm gonna make mine.
Well, that's very noble of you, darling. But you and your brother are going to get it all eventually. So why not take some of it now?
Because it's not the way I am. Not that you'd have any way of knowing that.
Well, I guess we know where you got your stubbornness.
So how was it, seeing Dad?
Well, we had a lovely time, actually. He took me to lunch, and we talked about our children. It's just that I...
What?
Well, I can't help it. I'm worried about him.
Worried about Dad? Why?
Well, he's still alone. He never remarried. And I'm afraid he's going to start depending on you for companionship.
You know what? You don't have to worry about that.
Oh, really? Do you think he's seen someone?
I know he is.
And now you'd know why I did what I did. I mean, here you are, a young woman, living in the most exciting city in the world. When I was your age, I was just stuck in Dogbat.
Sorry we weren't enough of a diversion for you, Mother.
I'm sorry, too. This visit isn't at all what I hoped for.
Really? I'm glad you came. Now I know you turned out exactly the way I thought you would. In fact, feel free to stop by again in another 12 years.
Oh, you are not housekeeping.
Are you Mrs. Brock?
I used to be, once upon a time. And you are?
Gil Chase. I do some business with your husband. Ex-husband.
Oh, what a coincidence. So do I. But I guess you already knew that. Otherwise, why would you be here?
Listen, if this is a bad time...
Oh, you'll come back another time, unannounced? Do you want a massage, Gil Chase?
Tempting. But, no thanks.
Leave us a minute.
Yes, Mrs. Brock.
Tell me, how do you know Brock?
We worked together on a deal.
Oh, let me guess. You're the one who helped him nail Alan Rush to the wall. And now he figures that he can sic you on me.
I'm just here to make you an offer. Brock wants to buy back your shares of his company.
So, Brock wants me out of his life, and he sent you to tell me.
I don't know. We only discuss business.
Well, I think if he hires you to do something as awkward as buy out his wife, the least he could do is tell you why.
Can I tell him that you're interested in the idea?
You tell him. It's a very interesting idea. You tell him. It's definitely something to think about.
Then I guess I'll be in touch.
In touch. Yes, I like that. Bye-bye, Gil Chase.
Friendly face.
Boy, you talk about an unholy alliance.
What is she doing with Alan Rush? What's going on here?
This is Diana Brock.
Well, half of me wants to know. The other half hopes I never have to find out. Excuse me, hon.
Alan?
Die? Hope you don't mind that I came. I figured it's only fair since I'm probably paying for this little shindig anyway, huh?
Ah, you really are the most generous man.
Yes, I am.
I'm sorry. Have we met? I'm sorry. Do we need to? I just assumed you knew. I'm Diana Brock.
Diana.
Oh, you didn't tell her I was in town.
I didn't think you still were.
I had no idea that you two know each other.
Actually, we just met, and it turns out, here we have some friends in common.
Sweetheart, are you all right? You seem flushed.
Excuse me. I need a minute.
So we'd have a chance to talk.
About what?
About Brock, of course. What else? Come on. You must have a million questions you want to ask me.
No, not really.
Really? Not one? Not even, what am I doing here?
All right. What are you doing here?
Well, I guess if I want to avoid a confrontation, I could tell you that, I'm just in town to see a couple of shows and do some shopping. But the truth is, I'm here to get back together with my husband.
If I were you, I'd stick to shopping.
You know, you never forget your first love, do you? I'm sure that you of all people know what I'm talking about. Because obviously there's no way you could stay married to that reptile Rush for so long. Unless you thought that you'd already had the great love of your life. And that's what I am to Brock. His first love. The one he'll never get over.
I'm not sure I understand the point of this. Do you expect me to fight you for Brock?
Listen, I spent 17 years with him. I gave birth to his children. I broke his heart. And now I'm back. So no, I don't expect you to fight me for him. What's the point? You haven't got a chance. I am so glad we had this chance to chat. Aren't you?
All right, we set? Good. You know, I wish like hell I could figure out what I did to make you disappear for 12 years so I could do it again.
Oh, don't tell me. You're not actually seriously stuck on that society iceberg.
Diana, you destroyed me once. Wasn't that enough?
I destroyed you? Oh, that's rich. I gave you 17 years. The best I had. The best any woman ever has. And what did you give me? Vacations in a tent? Cleaning that filthy fish you caught and playing Girl Scout? Then you finally discover that the good life is not on the edge of some mosquito-infested swamp. You get what I always wanted, what you wanted. This whole damn city at your feet. You think that I am going to turn around and go back to being just another Riviera and nobody? I'm not. If anyone's going to be Mrs. Adam Brock in this town, it's me. I've earned it.
Mrs. Brock.
Why, Mr. Chase, so you're in touch again. And getting more attractive by the day.
Thank you.
I don't know how your young Turks do it. Work all day, party all night, and still find time for the gym.
Not as much as I'd like to, actually.
Well, I'd say you're doing just fine. More than just fine. So, where are you taking me to lunch?
Actually, I hadn't planned on anything.
How disappointing. Here I am in the big city, and it looks like I'm going to be all alone.
Actually, I'm just here to tell you that Brock needs an answer before the end of the day regarding his offer to buy your stock.
Oh, poor Brock. He's still deluding himself. Why would I want to sell him my stock? It's the one sure thing in my life, and it keeps going up, up, up.
Yes, but his offer is very generous. It could be years before your shares hit the number he's offering.
Gil, spare me the dog and pony show, okay? I was Mrs. Adam Brock for 17 years, remember? And I don't deal through intermediaries, regardless of how charming they may be.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Brock, but I've been instructed to return with a definite response.
And here it is. Brock deals with me in person, or I dump all my shares of his company on the open market.
Excuse me?
You heard me.
You can't do that. It drives the price of the stock down, and you'd lose a fortune.
I already have a fortune, darling, but I'm not having any fun. So you tell Brock to meet me at 9 o'clock tonight at Tavern on the Green, or there's going to be an awfully big day on Wall Street tomorrow morning.
Brock had an unexpected business meeting, and it was very kind of you all to let me join you. I'm glad you can make it. Girls' night out.
So, has Carrie revealed the true purpose of this evening?
Nikki.
I'm afraid to ask. Should I make this a double?
Your daughter has a secret admirer. He sent her a bottle of champagne at the office and said he would meet her here tonight.
Well, it could be fun, as long as you check him out carefully.
Well, what's the point? Even if he's Prince Charming tonight, he'll turn into a frog next week like every other man in the city.
With that kind of cynical attitude, it's no wonder.
No wonder what?
It's no wonder you're not involved with somebody.
Oh, I guess I'm not as blindly trusting as you.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
No. You're trying to tell me something. What is it?
Well, Mom, I know who Brock's having dinner with tonight.
Who?
His ex-wife.
How do you know that?
I overheard it at the office.
I'm sure it's just business.
At Tavern on the Green? I'm sorry, Mom. I didn't want to say anything.
Maybe you misunderstood.
Well, why don't you go by and check it out for yourself?
Don't be ridiculous. I could never do that. But I think I will head for home.
Oh, Mom, I'm sorry. I didn't stay.
No, I didn't realize how tired I am. I really had a long day. Bye, Nikki.
Bye, Linda.
See you home. Be careful.
What did you go and have to do that for?
And the better that she knows now, or is it the idea of Brock leading her on and lying to her?
Compliments of the man at the end of the bar.
Really? Who?
Oh, I don't see him, but he was there a minute ago.
What did he look like?
Dark eyes, nice smile. He just had to give you champagne from a fresh bottle.
Well, whoever it is, he knows me well. That's vile. What did you put in there?
Nothing.
Well, where is the guy?
Looks like he disappeared.
I guess somebody doesn't like me very much.
We'll have Manhattan, the Bronx, and Staten Island too. It's lovely going through the zoo. It's very fancy on old Delancey Street, you know. The subway charms
a soul. Oh, look at you. Adam Brock having dinner at Tavern on the Green. Sipping champagne and listening to Bobby Short. I never thought I'd see the day.
Diana, stop talking about me like I was some sort of ape you just dragged in from captivity.
Oh, darling. Why not? It's half your charm. Oh, I'm just teasing you. Because you know how wild I was to come to New York all those years we were married. And you refused. You wouldn't even come for one weekend to see some plays and have dinner in a place like this.
I was a terrible, terrible man.
Well, just terribly unsophisticated.
Not about the things I cared for.
So, now you care about living in New York. Why?
Well, a lot of it has to do with business. Some of it has to do with wanting to live near Jordan. Your daughter, you remember her.
Oh, Brock, when are you going to find another axe to grind? I admit it. Maybe I was a bad mother. Immature, selfish, and too young. I was more interested in my own life than the lives of my children, but...
I am not here to fry you.
Then why do I feel the heat?
Diana, the only reason I am here is because I want to buy your stock.
And I'm here because I missed you, Brock. I think about you a lot. And when I ran into you here in New York... Well, it stirred up some pretty strong feelings. I admit, I've made some mistakes. We both have. But I'm willing to forgive you. And I want my family back.
Your family's all grown up, Diana. They don't need their mother anymore.
Brock, children always need their mother. Besides, what about us? We're still both single after all these years. Maybe we're destined to be together.
Have you so totally worn out every thrill that you're ready to come back to me?
Yes, I have. I mean, I am ready.
You know, there was a time that I would have done almost anything to hear you say that. I loved you so desperately. And I missed you so terribly. I stopped locking the doors at night. On the off chance that you might decide to walk back into my life. Had those plush towels you always fancied, and I kept the bed just exactly the way you wanted it. I wanted to be prepared, you understand?
Yes.
And then one day I woke up and I realized you were never coming home. So I burned the sheets, I burned the towels, I burned anything that had anything at all to do with you. And I swore to myself that if one day you had had enough of your shallow life and decided you wanted to come back to me, that I'd be a strong enough man to do the right thing.
Oh, Brock.
And tell you to go straight to hell.
Well, I see the big city hasn't dulled your southern charm.
All my killer instinct, Diana, so don't screw with me. You're gonna find yourself penniless in Monte Carlo.
Why, Brock, I think I just see a friend of yours. Oh, Linda. Over here.
Well, what a wonderful surprise. Don't tell us you're here all alone.
No, I'm here meeting friends for a drink. So if you'll excuse me.
Please, join us.
No, I wouldn't want to disturb such an intimate evening. Nice running into you both. Please don't.
The dreams of a boy in Doyle will turn Manhattan into an Isle of Joy.
I'm very late for an appointment, Brock, so I'm afraid I don't have time.
Linda, last night was just a big misunderstanding. I didn't mean to lie to you. I did have a business meeting, but it was with Diana.
I'm not an idiot, Brock. Nobody has a business meeting at 11 o'clock listening to Bobby Short in the most romantic restaurant in Manhattan.
Well, romance was the farthest thing from my mind.
I don't have time to play games, Brock. I just got out of a marriage of 13 years. I have no more time to waste. I can't risk getting involved with a man who's deceiving me while he's rekindling a flame with his ex-wife.
That is not the way it is. I'm not interested in her, honestly.
Doesn't matter. She's interested in you. And I don't compete for men. Do you understand?
Here, these for you.
I don't want them.
Linda, please.
Goodbye, Brock.
Mind if I join you?
I didn't think you would,
considering I'm still footing your bill here.
Stay away from the papaya. I think it went rancid someplace over the Pacific.
Look, I've given this a lot of thought, and I have a proposition for you.
Oh, Alan, I told you I don't want to sell my stock. Not to you, not to Brock, not to anyone.
I'm not talking about selling. What I am suggesting is a little swap. I'll give you a stake in my company for an equal number of your shares in Brock Communications. Not enough to set off any alarm bells at the SEC, but enough to give Brock a few sleepless nights.
Now, why would I want to do a thing like that? Brock hijacked communique from you right out from under your nose. How do I know someone else isn't going to come along and tear off another piece of your crumbling empire?
My empire is far from crumbling. In fact, it's worth a hell of a lot more than your ex-husband's. Just ask any financial advisor in town. Look, I'm offering you a ridiculously rich deal, one that you should jump at without hesitation.
All you men with all your offers makes my head spin. I have only one question. Why?
Revenge is an irrational act. And you have until exactly 10 a.m. tomorrow morning before I regain my senses.
I do expect to see you in my office.
Well, I hope you're here to accept my offer. Otherwise, we have nothing to talk about.
Ah, but you're not the only one throwing offers my way, big fella.
What are you talking about?
Alan Rush. He just made me quite a generous little offer of his own.
Diana, what are you up to?
Just a little stock swap, if you must know. I get a piece of his company. He gets a piece of yours.
You can't do that.
Why not? It's legal. And my financial advisors assure me that I'm getting the much better end of the bargain. So we'll be sealing the deal in his office first thing tomorrow morning.
Now you listen to me, Diana. You're getting yourself straight over to Kennedy. And you're concording yourself back to the crap tables in Monte Carlo.
Don't you dare tell me what to do. You had your chance, cowboy, and you blew it. So if I were you, I'd start kissing up to Alan Rush, because it looks like he's going to own a very big chunk of your company. And of you.
All right, those have been signed by me. Now all that's required is your countersignature.
My goodness. Gives me writer's cramp just looking at them. Could one of you nice gentlemen get me a glass of mineral water? Flat, room temperature, no ice. Now, could we go over this one more time?
It's really very simple. These documents authorize an exchange of 10,000 shares of common stock of Brock Communications with an equivalent 10,000 shares of Rush Media, along with various compulsory SEC disclosures.
Looks good to me. Where do I start?
How about... right, chow.
Diana, put down that damn pen. You can't do this.
Reality check, darling. My stock, my life. You have nothing to say about it.
Want to get the hell out of my office, please?
Stop. Let's go, Diana.
You honestly thought you could come in here, steal my magazine and my wife, and think you were going to get away with it? You don't have a clue who you're dealing with, do you?
Alan, you better get out of my face before I deck you.
That's good. Before you deck me.
Oh! Come on!
Brock!
All right, Diana. We're out of here.
Sorry, Alan. The deal is off.
Now.
You're gonna pay for this, Brock.
Look forward to it.
When are you going to learn to control that temper of yours?
When are you going to learn to stop making trouble?
Well, it felt just like the old times with you in there defending my honor.
Correction. I was defending my company.
Ah.
So, after 12 years as a silent partner, you've decided you want to start meddling with the business.
See, there you go again, always underestimating me. Has it ever occurred to you that I could actually be an asset?
No.
Then I guess I'll have to prove myself.
The only thing you've proven once again is that you are a world-class troublemaker. But trouble goes both ways. Now, I could have taken that stock from you years ago, but I didn't because I promised your daddy that you'd always be taken care of. Now, once and for all, Diana, what do you want?
How about a seat on your board of directors?
Fine, you got it. But don't make waves. Your father may have founded this company, but I'll be damned if I'll let you destroy it.
Oh, Brock.
I want you to send a dozen perfect roses every day with this message. Dear Linda, please forgive my love-struck insistence, but I can't stop thinking about you. Please turn off the damn answering machine and pick up the phone so we can talk. I miss you terribly. Brock.
That was very eloquent.
Linda. Boy, am I glad to see you.
I could tell you I came by to see my daughter, but that would be a lie. And the last thing I want to do is play games with you, Brock.
Please don't.
That means you have to be honest with me, too.
All right. How's this for starters? I think you are one incredibly sexy lady.
So what are you going to do about it?
Mm-hmm.
That's a good answer.
Now, how about having dinner with me tomorrow? You picked a place.
Are you sure you're not going to have a business meeting?
Honey, the only business I'm interested in right now is you.
Okay. I'll call you.
I'll be waiting.
Bye. Just can't seem to let go of the old place, can you? Actually, I was here to see Brock. Ah. Then I guess he told you that we've become business partners. No, your name didn't come up. And it feels just like old times. We were building my father's company together from scratch. Only now it's a media empire. And so much more exciting.
I can see you didn't waste much time staking your claim.
And I can see you didn't waste much time staking yours. What a cheap social climbing little gold digger.
Excuse me?
Oh, you think you're such a class act, Linda. But you're so obvious, it's pathetic. Dumping Alan the moment his business takes a bad turn, and then chasing after Brock like some lovesick teenager.
You have no idea what you're talking about.
I am very protective of Brock and our company, and there is no possible way you're going to sink your greedy little claws into either of them. Understand?
My God, you really are scared to death of me, aren't you? And you know what? You should be.